to Colorado, where ABC anchor David Muir is leading our coverage. Good morning, David.
Good morning, Bianna and Dan. And there were two major developments here overnight. First of all of that material taken from the suspect's apartment where there were booby traps and trip wires, that material taken to a field and ignited. They were testing for explosives. We'll show you those pictures in just a moment here. But first, as you mentioned, that brand new video of the suspect himself taken just a couple of years ago showing a teenager who loved science. Overnight, ABC News obtaining exclusive video and photographs of suspect James Holmes.
Hello, I'm James.
This is the first video released of the suspected shooter, recorded 6 years ago when Holmes was 18. Here he is standing in front of his peers at a science camp at Miramar College in San Diego, talking about what are called temporal illusions.
Over the course of the summer, I've been working with a temporal illusion. It's an illusion that allows you to change the past.
In the video, he appears slightly nervous speaking to the group, but he also appears intelligent. This is him explaining his mentor's shared interest in fantasy versus reality.
He also studies subjective experience, which is what takes place inside the mind as opposed to the external world. I've carried on his work in dealing with subjective experience.
Among fellow students, he appears to be a typical teenager with a particular interest in science. This is how he was introduced at the seminar.
His goals are to become a researcher and to make scientific discoveries. It's a good start. In personal life, he enjoys playing soccer and strategy games, and his dream is to own a Slurpee machine.
Meanwhile, overnight, there was also this. New pictures emerging of several explosions in a Colorado field where investigators took chemical materials recovered from the apartment of suspect James Holmes. Crews reportedly transporting the materials by dump truck to the field so that they could be ignited to determine if they were in fact explosive. And this morning, federal authorities and local police have now pulled all of the potential explosives from James Holmes' apartment after gaining entry. Once inside, carefully eliminating potentially explosive traps. You could even hear one of the explosives being disarmed. The police chief here said the suspect's intentions were clear.
This apartment was designed, I say, based on everything I've seen, to kill whoever entered it.
And this morning, as investigators continue to comb through what they pulled from his apartment, ABC News also learning that James Holmes' interests landed him a federal grant from the National Institutes of Health to study neuroscience, only one of a half dozen students to win one every year. He reportedly began the process of withdrawing from the PhD program this spring.
Now, the focus of that grant, according to the program, is to train outstanding neuroscientists who will, quote, make a significant contribution. There are reports that he began to struggle in that program, but real questions about how a student who showed so much promise, as you saw there in that video, could take such a dark turn. Those questions amid the president's visit here later today to meet with the victims' families.